discovered this benign substance was best medicine for me, I went about trying to educate the federal government.
What the marijuana does, very simple, is it relaxes the muscles going over these tumors, so when I move, the muscles are relaxed and they can move.
Hey Jim, it's Urban returning your phone call. Sorry I missed you.
Without it, I wouldn't be alive. I'm a very productive member of society, you know, instead of a person who'd be on disability.
Sometimes my legs will become so spastic, they will jump all over the place. I've discovered a few tokes and the spasticity just calms right down.
Living under pharmaceuticals, at least the ones that I was on, was like living underwater. Going to take a bath by yourself is an impossibility. Going swimming, it's an impossibility. Driving.
And it took us about almost 4 years to cut her completely off of pharmaceutical medication.
I was actually able, and I'm still able, to completely control my seizure activity. It doesn't mean that I don't have neurological problems, but it's a different world that I live in. To think that something I could grow myself that cost absolutely nothing, that would grow next to our lettuce and to our herbs and be such a powerful medicine to change my life, that was amazing.
Unfortunately, the real issue to this is some of our young kids think it's the wonder drug. It cures hangnails, headaches, back pains, everything you can think of.
Well, to me, it's an oxymoron. Medical and marijuana are two ends of a spectrum. I know over 100 moms that lost their children to drugs, and they all started with tobacco, a sip of beer, and a little weed, and that's the culprit.
Let's go, clear the rest of the house. Clear the rest of the house.
I opened my eyes and I saw three agents at that door and two agents at that door pointing assault rifles at my head.
I started answering them saying, I'm upstairs, I'm nonviolent, I'm not gonna resist, this is medical marijuana.
Today, members of WAM, Women's Alliance for Medical Marijuana, were stunned when federal agents raided WAM's greenhouse and garden shortly before noon and hauled away the entire pot crop of about 150 plants.
Everybody okay? Everybody's okay.
Go get a medicine
and
Valerie
and Microsoft, they put them on the floor.
Oh my God!
DEA has a responsibility, as long as marijuana is a Schedule I controlled substance, to enforce it.
My name is Yvonne, and I am not a criminal.
In the mid-1970s and 1975, I was arrested for growing 4 marijuana plants and argued before the criminal court that any person who was sane, who knew they were going blind, and who knew that marijuana could help to prolong their sight, would break the law in order to obtain marijuana. The judge concluded that it was correct that any sane person would break the law in order to save their own eyesight, and I was found not guilty.
The problem is, we haven't, to my knowledge, seen those studies. We haven't seen the proof.
People who diminish the importance of anecdotal evidence behave as though medicine didn't know anything until the large double-blind study, and we didn't know anything about drugs until that happened.
Once you basically got a threshold in your body, you could feel it work. You can feel it work.
These receptors are located in the precise parts of the brain that we would expect to find receptors that are involved in pain, motor function, memory, mood. And in a patient with chronic pain, perhaps that system's not working well enough or it's gone wrong, adding THC from outside binds to these receptors, calms the system down a bit, and you end up with the overall effect, which may be pain relief.
What we called success in this study was people who had a greater than 30% reduction in the average daily pain, and this was pretty close to almost 50%. Something that was widely used and available as a drug until 1942, because it had purported benefit, might not be a surprise if it still does.